We want to find all of the zeros of the degree 3 polynomial function and then write p of x as a product of linear factors. So for a quick review, the complex factorization theorem states that if we have a polynomial of degree n, then there are exactly n complex zeros as long as we count multiplicity. So if we find all the complex zeros, then we can write the given polynomial function as a product of linear factors, as we see here, where the r's would be the zeros and the exponents m would be the multiplicity of each zero. Also notice that a would be the leading coefficient in this form. So going back to our example, instead of using the rational roots theorem to find our real rational zeros of the function, we're actually going to graph the function and find the real rational zeros as x-intercepts of the function. So if we graph this polynomial function, it looks like this. And notice how we do have an x-intercept here. This x-intercept is negative 4, where the point would be negative 4, comma 0. Notice when x is negative 4, the y-value of the function value is 0, and therefore x equals negative 4 is a 0. So if we're keeping track of our zeros up here, we already know that one of them would be x equals negative 4. But because we know negative 4 is a 0 of this degree 3 polynomial function, we should also be able to recognize that that means x plus 4 would be a factor of this polynomial function, which means we can write p of x as p of x equals the linear factor of x plus 4. Notice x equals negative 4 makes this factor equal to 0. The remaining factor would be a degree 2 factor or a quadratic factor. So to find this quadratic factor, we're going to take our polynomial function and divide by x plus 4. So if we want to take x cubed plus 4x squared plus 9x plus 36 and divide this by x plus 4, we could use either long division or synthetic division. Let's go ahead and use synthetic division to perform this division. So for dividing by x plus 4, we're going to use the constant or the 0 negative 4 for synthetic division. And now we'll list the coefficients of our polynomial function here, which are 1, 4, 9, and 36. And now to perform the synthetic division, we bring down this first term here, 1, and start multiplying by negative 4. Negative 4 times 1 is negative 4. And then we add, that would be 0. Negative 4 times 0 is 0. And we add, that's 9. Negative 4 times 9 is negative 36. And we add, and that's 0. This last 0 is important because this represents the remainder, which should be 0 since we know x plus 4 should be a factor. And this verifies that it is. This also tells us the quotient is 1x squared plus 0x plus 9, or just x squared plus 9. And therefore, if this quotient equals x squared plus 9, the polynomial function would have to be x plus 4 times x squared plus 9. And we are expecting 3 zeros since we have a degree 3 polynomial function. So now we're left to find the zeros of x squared plus 9. So to do this, we'll set this factor equal to 0 and solve for x. Let's go and do this on the next slide. So again, our goal is to find the zeros of the factor x squared plus 9. So we'll set x squared plus 9 equal to 0 and solve. This is not factorable, so we could use the quadratic formula. But since there's no x term, we can solve this using square roots. We would subtract 9 on both sides, and then take the square root of both sides to solve for x. Don't forget the plus or minus here to get our two solutions. So we have x equals plus or minus the square root of negative 9 would be negative 1 times 9. So this is an imaginary number. The square root of negative 1 is I. Square root of 9 is 3, so we have x equals plus or minus 3i. So going back to our first slide, we now know the other two zeros. One is x equals 3i, and the other is x equals negative 3i. Now we can completely factor p p of x into three linear factors. We would have p of x equals the quantity x plus 4 times x minus 3i times x minus negative 3i, which would be x plus 3i. Again, each of these factors is x minus the zero of the polynomial function. So now we have everything. We found the zeros, and we also wrote the polynomial as a product of linear factors. I hope you found this helpful.